for me, it was a level of intensity driven by Joe and the management that just couldn't be sustained. And at that psychological level of intensity, that's a lack of fun, that's a lack of empowerment. It's players not really having a healthy sense of empowerment in any way. Players being having their heads ripped off by management for making mistakes. It just starts to, you know, if we heard it once, we heard it 100 times, the infamous Monday morning blood on the floor video sessions. Like, there's more than one way to raise a child. You know, there are parents who have a laissez-faire attitude who probably are complete liberals. There are parents who are completely strict. There are parents who are somewhere in the middle. There's management styles within an office group, within a business, and within a sports team. And you do not need to go in and have blood on the floor every Monday, you know, and handpick out every, and in slow motion go through every error. So there's a, you've raised a culture of fear among players, which there absolutely was. And then you start getting high grade elite level players looking like amateurs on a field. And that's a psychological thing that when I hear Joe come out and say, there's nothing I would have done different, it's startling, you know. Or you hear, there was a lead up into the World Cup of talking about, you're hearing players perpetuate these lines such as, you know, Joe and Johnny know what's going to happen on the field before it's happened. You know, really is rubbish. And it's like a, you know, an internal loop within the group where they're, you know, reinforcement within the group. All is good. Johnny and Joe know what's going to happen in the future. And you're hearing Chris Farrell come out and saying, I like playing with him because he knows what's going to happen in 10 minutes time. Well, they don't. Nobody does. But when you hear it and you remove yourself from it, these are problems. That's a culture within that group that's gone wrong. And, you know, it manifests itself in the most basic looking handling errors, the fact we couldn't physically compete in any way when we could 12 months ago. New Zealand didn't get excessively stronger than we did 12 months ago. We just couldn't physically summon up the energy levels to take them on. We were falling off collisions from about 5 minutes in. Rory Best got smashed after about 3 minutes and, you know, took time to get up off the floor. You know, that can happen, but it happened across the board. And to me, that's instructive. It shows there's a much deeper issue going on. And I think it started to just crumble apart in 2019.